Okay, right, here we go again. First Tuesday of our April programme. Hope you're all sitting comfortably. Hope you all had a good Pesach. Now look forward to Shavuos, I think. Get baking those cheesecakes shortly. Delighted as always to welcome Brian here. Brian's so well known to all of us. Brian's talk this afternoon. Let me just read for you. Have you ever wondered why it sounds familiar? Familiar tune, familiar sound? Brian tells us he has all the answers and will enlighten us as to the reasons why. So, Brian, into your capable hands, I give
you. Thank you very much. I will do my best to enlighten you. It is a question of hearing something and thinking, well, that resembles something else. It may be words that have been added simply to music, or it may be another version of the same song. And I'm going to give examples of those things this afternoon and one or two other similar things. It gives me the opportunity to play some classical music for a time and some old favorites. And I'll be explaining where the links are. Anyhow, I'm going to start with this one.
Just one cornetto, give it to me. Delicious ice cream and memory. Oh, love, by the ice cream side. Just one cornetto and see. Just one cornetto on the
heart. There we are. Now, if we were all back in the shore, this would be the moment, I think, when the committee would come down amongst us with trays of ice cream. But sadly, nothing like that today. The ice is outside. But the song is based on one of the most popular Neapolitan songs of the past 100 years. Its title translates as My Sunshine, and the song talks about the beauty of a sunny day in southern Italy, which we can possibly imagine a little because it's really quite sunny outside at the moment. But let's hear the original.
Quando farò teo sole se ne scende. Ma
There we are, a beautiful song, and as you saw, sung by Pavarotti. And this is where it sounds familiar, because hearing that song, it's just possible that you can connect it to one of the greatest pop singers. And this is his version of that song.
Kiss me, mother, be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's not a minute, my love, won't wait. When I first saw you, with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrounded. Hearts were like time, waiting for the right time. Now that you're near, time is here at last. It's love or never. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be tonight. It's not a minute, my love won't wait. Just like a willow, you would cry in ocean. If we lost true love and sweet devotion, your lips excite me, but your arms invite me. For who knows when we'll meet again this way. It's love or never. Come hold me tonight. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be tonight. It's not a minute, my love won't wait. It's not a minute, my love. It's not a my love won't wait.
It's not a my love won't.
There we are. Elvis was a real phenomenon and actually a great singer. He could also act and play music, and he's regarded as one of the most significant cultural icons of the 20th century. And that song, Now or Never, was his best-selling single with over 20 million copies. It's also one of the best-selling singles of all time. And those of you may recall a talk to Sage by David Fishoff, and he said in that apparently in Elvis's early days, he used to, on Shabbos, he used to do various duties for a local Jewish neighbor of his. Now for something a little quieter than that.
Thank you.
There we are. It's nice to be able to play that delightful classical music. That dance music comes from an exotic scene in the opera Prince Igor by Alexander Borodin. Borodin was interesting. He was a Russian doctor, a chemist, and a composer in the 19th century, but music for him was only a secondary vocation. He worked on Prince Igor for 10 years, and yet it was still unfinished when he died suddenly, aged only 43. And Rimsky-Korsakov and Glazunov both completed it for him. I hope it struck a chord with you, remembering perhaps that it was used in a successful 1950s Broadway musical and in the follow-up film. And this is where the music reappeared.
Take my hand, I'm a stranger in paradise, all lost in a wonderland, a stranger in paradise. If I stand starry-eyed, that's a danger in paradise. For mortals who stand aside, an angel like you, I saw your face, and I assembled into the rare, somewhere in space, I hang suspended until I know there's a chance that you care. Won't you answer this fervent prayer of a stranger in paradise? Don't send me in dark despair from all that I hunger for. But open your angel's arms to the stranger in paradise and tell him that he need be a stranger no more.
There we are, a song from Kismet, a musical Arabian Nights, which had most of its music was based on Borodin's original melodies, like that one. The musical won a Tony Award for Best Musical of the Year, and Borodin was awarded a Tony posthumously. Now, moving on to a different kind of similarity, something by Cole Porter. He was a marvelous composer and lyricist, a great admirer of Gilbert and Sullivan. And I'm going to play one of his Liszt songs in the GNS style. One of the few composers in those days who came from a very wealthy background in his years. His early life was fascinating and he included a spell actually in the French Foreign Legion. But later, following a riding accident, he spent the last years of his life suffering in great pain. But this was one of his marvelous songs.
Birds do it, bees do it, even educated fleas do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. In Spain, the best upper sets do it. Lithuanians, and let's do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. The Dutch in old Amsterdam do it. Not to mention the Finns. Folks in Siam do it. Think of Siamese twins, some Argentines without means do it. People saying in Boston, even beans do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Romantic sponges, they say, do it. Oysters down in Oyster Bay, do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Cold cake, cod clams, against their wish, do it. Even lazy jellyfish do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Electric eels, I might add, do it. Though it shocks him, I know. Why ask if Shad do it? Way to bring me Shad and Roe in shadow shows. English souls do it. Goldfish in the privacy of bowls do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love.
There we are. Ella, now on this side of the Atlantic, there was Sir Noel Coward, a talented playwright. He was a composer, he was a director, he was an actor and a singer, which is really quite something for one man. And Time magazine said that he had a personal style, which was a combination of cheek and chic and posed and poised. And that, I think, summed him up quite well. Now, he couldn't resist having a go at Cole Porter's song, but in his own inimitable style. So I wonder how many of the names that he mentions in this song that you remember, going back quite a while.
Mr. Irving Berlin often emphasizes sin in a charming way. Mr. Coward, we know, wrote a song or two to show sex was here to stay. Richard Rogers, it's true, took a more romantic view of this sly biological urge, but it really was Cole who contrived to make the whole thing merge. He said that Belgians and Greeks do it, nice young men who sell antiques do it, Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Monkeys, whenever you look, do it. Ali Khan and King Farouk, do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. Luella Parsons can't quite do it. But she's so highly strung. Marlena might do it. But she looks far too young. Each man out there shooting crap does it. Davy Crockett in that dreadful cap does it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. All famous writers in swarms do it. Somerset and all the norms do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. The Brontes felt that they must do it. Ernest Hemingway could just do it. Let's do it. Let's fall in love. E. Allan Poe, ho, 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 did it. But he did it in verse. H. Beecher Stowe did it, but she had to rehearse. Tennessee Williams, self-taught, does it. Kinsey with a deafening report, does it. Let's do it, let's go and love. In the spring of the year, inhibitions disappear and our hearts beat high. We had better face facts, every gland that overacts has an alibi. For each bird and each bee, each slap happy sappy tree, each temptation that lures us along, is just nature, L-man, merely singing us the same old song. In Texas, some of the men do it. Others drill a hole and then do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. West Point cadets forming fours do it. People say all those gabals do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. Mike and Kim more or less do it. Every uncle and aunt, that I confess to it. I've one cousin that can't. Teenagers squeezed into jeans do it. Probably will live to see machines do it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. Each baby bat after dark does it. In the desert, Wilbur Clark does it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. We're told that every hormone does it. Victor Borger all alone does it. Let's do it, let's fall in love. Each tiny clam you consume does it. Even Liberace, we assume, does it. Let's do it.
There we are, his Noel Coward's version. And now something delightful from Mozart, a genius, really, if ever there was one. He composed four horn concertos, and this is the final movement of number four, his horn concerto number four. It's clearly allied to an open-air hunting horn. And just a bit of incidental knowledge here, he wrote probably his best three operas, in my opinion, The Marriage of Figaro, Don Giovanni, and Così fan tutte, with a Jewish-born librettist, Lorenzo da Ponte, but that's a story for another day. So this is Mozart's Horn Concerto number four. Thank you. Moved on to something else there. But just as delightful is this song on the same subject by Flanders and Swann. They were a wonderful comedy duo appearing on stage with just a piano and a wheelchair for Flanders. Their shows were called At the Drop of a Hat and At the Drop of Another Hat. And Flanders was always in the wheelchair, having contracted polio when he was 21. Flanders played the piano, and it was Swann who played the piano, rather. I saw both shows, and I actually remember them quite well. I took a young schoolgirl with me on one occasion. I was in my teens, and apparently she became quite famous in later life, I've heard. But this was their take on the Mozart piece, and they relate to it with a horn and following the music very, very closely.
Once had a whim and I had to obey it to buy a French horn in a second-hand shop. I polished it up and I started to play it in spite of the neighbors who begged me to stop. To sound my horn, I had to develop my embouchure. I found my horn was a bit of a devil to play. So awfully wound to give you a sound, a beautiful sound, so rich and round. Oh, the hours I had to spend before I mastered it in swing. But that was yesterday, and just today I looked in the usual place. There was the case, but the horn itself was missing. Where can it have gone? Haven't you? Hasn't anyone seen my horn? Where can it have gone? What a blow, now I know. Am I able to play my Allegro? Who swiped that? All I bet you would win, somebody did. Knowing I'd found a concerto and wanted to play it, afraid of my talent of playing a horn. For early today, to my utter dismay, it had vanished away like the tuning of a horn. I've lost that horn. I know I was using it yesterday. I've lost that horn. Lost that horn. Found that horn. Gone. I know some party folk whose party jokes pretending to hunt with a corn. Gone away, gone away. Was it one of them took it away? Can you return that horn? Oh, where is the devil who pinched my horn? I should tell the police. I want that French horn back. I miss its music more and more and more. Without that horn, I'm feeling sad and so forlorn. I found a concern of a broken display and display. I found a pain for horn, but nearly to think of my heart in display, it had totally vanished away. I practiced the horn and I wanted to play.
play it, but somebody took it away. I practiced the horn and was longing to play it, but somebody took it away. My neighbor's asleep in his bed. I'll soon make him wish he were dead. I'll take up the tuner and say, wah, wah.
There we are. I don't know if any of you remember going to see either of them. It was they were terrific, actually, and their songs are still funny. Going back now to a popular tune, which was all the rage in the 1960s, which you might have seen as I put the wrong note on the screen. It won a Grammy Award for the Record of the Year in 1965. It was written by Carlos Jobim, and the hit record had Astrud Gilberto singing and Stan Getz playing the saxophone. Getz was actually a nice Jewish boy from the East End of London, though he had found his way to America. His playing, as you can hear, has a warm lyrical tone, and he's been described as one of the leading great saxophonists of all time. And this is how it sounded.
Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently, that when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. Oh, but we watch her so sadly. Walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at he.
Us on to another nice Jewish boy, fortunately still with us, although he's aged 91, celebrations recently about reaching 91. Stephen Sondheim has been praised for reinventing the American musical. After a very sad family life, Sondheim creates his own families with each new musical that he writes and produces. And this song that I'm going to play comes from an off-Broadway musical review, which was called The Mad Show. It's Sondheim's take on The Girl from Ipanema. I think this is a wonderful version. It's by Millicent Martin, if you remember Millicent Martin from the week that was. And she deals faultlessly with the place name that you will be able to see on the slide.
by, and I have to follow him. Boy from Takaran Malatuma del Fuego, Santa Malika Zacatecas, so on to Del Soli Cruz. When we meet, I feel I'm on fire and I'm breathless. Every time I inquire, how are things in Tacaramba, La Tumba del Fuego, Santa Malika, Zacatecas, go on to Del Soli Cruz. Why is he acting so clannish? Why, when I speak, does he vanish? I wish I understood Spanish. When I tell him I think he's the end, he giggles a lot with his friend. Tall and slender, moves like a dancer, but I never seem to get any answer from the boy from Tacaramba, La Tumba del Fuego, Santa Malika, Zacatecas, so on to Del Soli Cruz. I got the blues. Why are his trousers vermilion? His trousers are vermilion. Why does he claim he's Castilian? He says he's Castilian. Why do his friends call him Lillian? And I hear at the end of the week, he's leaving to start a boutique. So I smile, I'm only pretending, cause I know today's the last I'll be spending with the boy from Tacaramba, La Tumba del Fuego, Santa Malika, Zacatecas, go on to Del Soli Cruz. Tomorrow he sails, he's moving to Wales to live in a clan marble thing. Go, get a Juan Robo, Fantasilio, go, go, go.
There we are. I think she is magnificent. And so on now to two more nice Jewish boys, slightly different, there's some familiarity. Danny Kaye was just starting out when he hit the jackpot with a song which was written by Ira Gershwin and Kurt Weill. It was in a musical called Lady in the Dark, in which he played opposite Gertrude Lawrence. It's a torrent of tongue-twisting verbiage in which he sings the name of 49 Russian composers at great speed. In fact, each night, apparently, he tried to do it faster than the night before. See if you can make out most of the names. Here we go.
Esmala, Chetsky, Rubin, Sana, Rensky, and Tchaikovsky, Sapelnikov, Dmitriev, Cherepnik, Krizhinovsky, Kudovsky, Arthur, Buchev, Moni, Yuskovaki, Menko, Soropiev, Prokofiev, Yamkin, Goroshenko, Deus, Lipo, Lutra, Bosniansky, Repta, Kofilinsky, Desmetr, Balakirov, Zolotorov, and Kosinski, and Sokolov, and Kopolov, Dukelsky, and Konovsky, and Shostakovich, Boga, Dinglier, and Novakovsky, Desliyedov, and Karganov, Markeyevich, Panchenko, and Argomisky, Chervachevsky, Rabin, Vasilenko, Stravinsky, Rimsky, Prosakov, Musovsky, and Grachaninov, and Glazunov, and Sezak, Vikalinik, and Lakhanov, Stravinsky, I really ought to stop. The subject has been brought to Palinov.
There we are. Very quick. And the familiarity this time, if I come up here, the familiarity, in this case, it's not quite as direct as in some of the others, but it's simply another torrent of tongue twisters, this time by another elderly but wonderful Jewish artist, still with us, age 92. He's no longer writing his fabulous songs and long since retired. It's Tom Lehrer. And this is his version of a verbal torrent.
Aluminum, selenium, and hydrogen, and oxygen, and nitrogen, and rhenium, and nickel, neodymium, neptunium, germanium, and iron, americium, ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, and lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, and gold, protactinium, and indium, and gallium, and iodine, and thorium, and thulium, and thallium. There's yttrium, ytterbium, actinium, rubidium, and boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, and strontium, and silicon, and silver, and samarium, and bisulfuramine, lithium, beryllium, and barium. There's holmium, and helium, and hafnium, and erbium, and phosphorus, and francium, and fluorine, and terbium, and manganese, and mercury, molybdenum, and magnesium, dysprosium, and scandium, and cerium, and cesium, and lead, praseodymium, and platinum, and plutonium, palladium, promethium, potassium, polonium, and tantalum, technetium, titanium, tellurium, and cadmium, and calcium, and chromium, and curium. There's sulfur, californium, and fermium, berkelium, and also mendelevium, einsteinium, nobelium, and argon, krypton, neon, radon, xenon, zinc, and rhodium, and chlorine, carbon, cobalt, copper, tungsten, tin, and sodium. These are the only ones of which the news has come to Harvard, and there may be many others, but they haven't been discovered.
I think that's great. He also plays the piano as well. And all of his songs are still worth listening to. It's been some time since he wrote that song. As he mentions at the end, you can hear, he allowed for the fact that there may be some new elements to be added in the future. In fact, there have been a number of new elements, but I'm not aware of him actually writing a new song and adding them in at the end. And so I'm moving on to my last two examples. Amilcare Ponchielli was an Italian opera composer in the 1800s, and he wrote a symphony by the time he was 10 years old. He was best known for his opera La Gioconda, which contained a short ballet called The Dance of the Hours, and it's one of the best known and frequently performed ballets, and its fame grew after it was included in the Disney film Fantasia. It also happens to be one of the most frequently parodied pieces of classical music. And this is what it sounds like.
Brian, we've lost the sound.
Sorry, thank you. Thank you. I'm sure you all know what's coming now. Alan Copelon, better known as Alan Sherman, was actually a television producer, a singer, an actor, and as you know, a comedy writer before he became quite famous as a song parodist, much in the vein in those days of Mickey Katz. And the song we all remember, which I think works best, is this one. Certainly for anyone who's ever been to a summer holiday camp, perhaps like the one that I went to, and I still remember fondly in Felixstowe in those far off distant days, they'll find that this song rings remarkably true.
Mother, hello father, here I am at Camp Granada. Camp is very entertaining, and they say we'll have some fun if it stops raining. I went hiking with Joe Spivey, he developed poison ivy. You remember Leonard Skinner, he got tomate poisoning last night after dinner. All the counselors hate the waiters, and the lake has alligators, and the head coach wants no sissies, so he reads to us from something called Ulysses. Now I don't want this should scare you, but my bunkmate has malaria. You remember Jeffrey Hardy, they're about to organize a searching party. Take me home, oh mother father, take me home. I hate Granada, don't leave me out in the forest where I might get eaten by a bear. Take me home, I promise I will not make noise or mess the house with other boys. Oh, please don't make me stay, I've been here one whole day. Dearest Fada, darling Mata, how's my precious little brother? Let me come home if you miss me. I would even let Aunt Bertha hug and kiss me. Wait a minute, it stopped hailing. Guys are swimming, guys are sailing, playing baseball, gee, that's better. Modafada, kindly disregard this ladder.
There we are. So I hope you've enjoyed the music and the songs, followed the familiarities that I think I've tried to explain. And they're just a few examples, there are many of them, but perhaps those are the ones that are best known.
Right, thank you so much. What a wonderful one to finish on with Alan Sherman. It still makes me laugh every way through it, even though you know what's coming.
Yeah.
And to hear people as well, we haven't heard from Millicent Martin, Ella Fitzgerald, Danny Kaye, they go on forever. Wonderful session, Brian. Thank you for all that lovely entertainment and
pleasure.
Variety of music. Just before you all dash off, and you're welcome to stay and chat, I just want to talk about next Tuesday. Next Tuesday, we've got the Deputy Israeli Ambassador to London. Very lucky to get her, and this has been arranged for us by Alan Aziz from Technion. Technion are Israel's Institute of Technology, and Alan is the Managing Director of Technion UK. Technion UK are the leading British organisation promoting education, science and technology, and obviously well supported by the Israeli head office. But the reason I mention it is because Alan has advertised this on a poster on their website, both in Israel and across Europe. And his website and his notification goes out to many people who subscribe to their newsletter as well. When Alan first advised us about this session, he asked if he could open it up to other people. And we said, or I said, we didn't have a problem as long as the SAGE people could come on and get priority. What's happened is that Alan has put this notification out. I've agreed with him that people have to apply to join. They won't be given the Bushy SAGE connection, Bushy Zoom page. They have to apply, and Alan will then give them the details. I've agreed that the most they can have is up to 300 people, which allows plenty of capacity for SAGE people. But the reason I'm really mentioning it is that I just advise you to join us a bit earlier, perhaps than normal next week, because I would hate you to miss out on what should be a very interesting talk, as I say, from the Deputy Israeli Ambassador to London. So please join us next Tuesday for that. Join us perhaps a little bit earlier than normal, so you can definitely get onto the system. On Tuesday of this week, we have the first session delivered by Irving Krem for Current Affairs. Thursday. Please join us on Thursday for Irving. It's his first session. Give him your support. So with that, I shall wish you a good afternoon. Please stay on if you wish to chat for a while, and look forward to seeing you Thursday, and look forward to seeing you next Tuesday. Take care.
Brian, it's Daphne. Just my usual thank you so, so much. It was great. I really enjoyed it. And it was really, really interesting to see the connections. And as always, you never say no to me. You always come up trumps. Thank you very, very much.
Pleasure. This is a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Lovely, lovely. Loved it. Enjoyed it.
We enjoyed it too. Thank you.
Terrific. Yeah. Please join us on Thursday. Those who don't join Current Affairs are missing out. A really nice chatty session. So Thursday, 2 o'clock, same place, same time.
Hi, everybody.
Bye.
Be well.
Yes.
Bye.
Brian.
Yes.
Brian, can I recommend that you listen to Glenn Miller's Girl in Kalamazoo?
Yes.
Right. Followed by the Johnny Keating Orchestra in their version of Kalamazoo. It will definitely want to make you get up and dance.
Okay.
I promise you that.
All right. I'll follow that. Okay. Thanks. Okay.
Will it make you get up and dance, Harold?
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you for the idea. I'll follow it. Bye.
Bye. Bye now.
The start of another session for you, Brian.